Welcome to NC Catholics Now. We're here at Cathedral because Seminarian Johan Salas was recently ordained to the transitional diaconate. Now, he's known throughout the parishes he's served in and in the diocese as someone who likes to ask a lot of questions, enjoys laughing, has a great sense of humor, and also is musically inclined. Now, we caught up with him recently to ask about his childhood, his discernment, and what he's looking forward to now that he's a transitional deacon.
I really love the Eucharist, love the sacraments, and the work of the priest. So I wanted to be part of that. I am a seminarian from the Diocese of Raleigh, and I am doing my pastoral year at St. Michael's in Kerry. So I'm coming from a middle-class family in Colombia, and my father, he worked in different things, like construction. My mom, she was always home, taking care of us. So five boys in a house for a mom is not easy. So my town is called Montelíbano. Montelíbano is a town in the coast of Colombia. It's in the north. We have two oceans in Colombia, and this is part of the Atlantic. That area is like Caribbean. So a lot of fish. The weather is always hot. We play outside a lot. Yeah. I mean, I was a decent student. Always good grades. Once I finished my high school, I moved to Bogota, which is the capital of Colombia, and I started my formation with Dominicans. I have a brother who is a priest in New Jersey. He's from the Diocese of Patterson. And I was working in Colombia, and I used to come here and visit him to help him in his parish. With the Hispanic community. And I went to a retreat during that time, that I came here. And so during that retreat, the calling of God was still in my heart. It was, you know, moving me to think more about the priesthood.
Well, there are a lot of things about him. He's smart, he's spiritual, he's pious, and he knows what he wants. And that's the more important thing, you know. And when you act like that, you just let the Holy Spirit to guide you. So he's very open to the work of the Holy Spirit in his life.
So Johan came 3 years ago to study for priesthood for the diocese, but it was during the summer. So seminary had not begun yet. He didn't have any family in North Carolina. We got the call from the Office of Vocations if we would house him and be a home base. And he brought a ukulele. And so anytime you have a guest come in and they bring a musical instrument, I think it just lowers our nervousness about someone that they have interest in outside. And music, what usually brings to mind a festiveness about someone. And so he brought in the ukulele and that sparked a conversation, and it was a great intro to getting to know him.
He speaks both English and Spanish well. He's going to be able to relate well to lots of different kinds of people. And especially here, I'm thinking here in the Research Triangle area, which is an increasingly diverse area and increasingly, we say this a lot of times in our parishes, that if we're not careful, our parishes can become a bunch of little parishes all meeting under one roof. He's going to be that man of communion who's able to gather us all at the one altar. At the end of the day, St. Paul says in Ephesians, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And then elsewhere talks about the one bread and the one cup.
We are blessed to be here, to be with him, and to live this moment of blessing for him. It's been like a very, very, very touching mass. The bishop says a word that really touched us, the heart was all in tears. It was like very nice. And we thank God to be here.
So he brings an ability to connect with teaching, with music, with a spiritual life of service, a devotion to Mary, and he brings already a leadership among himself and the other seminarians. He's very pleasant to be around.
I think Jesus is always taking over our life. Yeah, and we need to die to ourselves to let him live. And I think that is a big part of my life and formation. My entire life is going to be for Jesus, for God, for the church, and for this diocese.
Thank you so much for watching NC Catholics Now. We leave you with some words from Bishop Luis Rafael Zarama, who during his homily encouraged Deacon Johan to continue to embrace who he is, as he continues his journey. Take care.
And give thanks to God for the vocation. A man that the Lord chose and set aside, not from the people of Israel, from the people of God. He chose you from the beginning of creation. And you make your journey to this day. Sometimes you take turns in your life. You try to figure out your vocation. You work hard. And look at that where you're now. A beautiful journey.